Hey, so today I watched Sometimes, Always, Never, and it was really good. I really liked it. When I first heard the title, I originally got confused with Never, Rarely, Sometimes, Always, which I had previously seen, and I think previously reviewed, because it was also this year. It was also really critically acclaimed. That was actually the most critically acclaimed movie of the year so far. This one isn't quite as critically acclaimed, but audiences like it more. This one just seems to be pretty well liked by everyone, despite it being a very notably indie film. But it has a very commendable Bill Nighy performance. Not Bill Nighy as in the science guy. need to make that distinction. It's very visually pleasant, and its humor is very quirky and unique. It also just brings a lot of new, fresh ideas, and I don't know, it just feels very different from a lot of things. It definitely stands on its own as like I just liked how I'm having trouble exactly pinpointing why everything felt so fresh and felt so delightful, but it just did. I love the cinematography, I love the acting, I love the writing of the humor. Everything just felt like odd and like lovable. I'm trying to figure out how best to explain like my feelings on this movie because I did really enjoy it. I guess it went into like a story that was unexpected for a story to be gone into. Like, there aren't really any other movies about Scrabble that I can think of, because it's like, who would do a movie about Scrabble? That's just weird. But here it totally works, and somehow it's not boring. It's actually a very interesting movie, and the movie's not all about Scrabble. It's not like a boring movie about that. It's more so like a dramedy and about like this father-son relationship at the heart of it. And it just, yeah, it's mostly like it's got this family drama at the core behind all of the British humor and all of that. That's very delightful for any cinema fan. But yeah, I'd highly recommend it. I'd give it what, 9 out of 10? Very light 9 out of 10, like closer to an 8.5 than even a 9.25 out of 10. But yeah, definitely go watch it, and go watch Never Rarely, Sometimes Always. If I didn't review that one, I gave an 8.